bunker's been making noise.
What kind of noise?
It's online. Some people have noticed. Script kiddies, mostly. Nothing to worry about. I'll make sure they stay out. We've been probed a few times.
Probed?
There is only one that worries me. His name is Default, and he's very good. I'll watch him.
Let me know if he becomes a problem.
Keep moving.
All right, I left the truck for you.
God damn, this plan might actually work. All right, now, you're gonna need security clearance to get inside Bloom HQ. Have you ever chased a helicopter? And no, that is not a philosophical question.
I've been chased by a few. What does that have to do with anything?
Call it a hunch. We'll talk soon.
Alright guys, welcome back for more Watch Dogs. I've been away for a week because I have been covering for a job, for my job, so I've been away from the internet for a while, as well as my console, so I'm back. And I'm about to give you guys a lot of Watch Dogs. I may not finish it this week, but I will have it done at some point. As far as Microsoft's Xbox One goes, I'm not really excited about it anymore. I mean, the only real exciting game or exciting addition that I saw from E3 was the Master Chief Collections. You know, pretty much the whole Halo 1, 2, 3, and Halo 4 all sort of combined into one giant disc. Remastered on HD for the Xbox One, you know, 1080p, 60 frames per second. And I mean, that's pretty much it. I mean, all the other games announced are pretty much multi-platform, so they're on Xbox One, PS4 as well. So, and I'm pretty much going to be playing all the games on my PlayStation 4 because graphically, I know they're going to be, you know, 1080, they're going to be 60 frames or 30 frames, and they're going to be great. As far as Sony goes, Sony definitely blew me out of the water with the Killzone DLC, the infamous Second Son DLC, definitely from the trailer. Made me want to actually pick it up because it definitely had some new additions. I hope we can actually explore a sort of snow landscape that was shown in the trailer. The Order 1886, definitely can't wait for that. Little Big Planet, not so much. I didn't really play it on the PS3. One of the games that really sort of surprised me, or sort of had like a part in E3, was definitely Rockstar. Rockstar never shows up or never any part of E3s, and they sort of wait for their own sort of leisure to announce games. So when Sony, during their press conference, sort of announced that Grand Theft Auto 5 was indeed coming to next-gen hardware, and I was definitely impressed. I definitely wasn't expecting that. Definitely a mind-boggling. But I'm excited. I'm playing Watch Dogs. But so it'll be interesting to see how Watch Dogs compares to Grand Theft Auto. I mean, I know Grand Theft Auto 5 has already been released for past gen Xbox 360 and PlayStation 3, but to actually see the game being remastered, sort of, and be played on the...
What the fuck, anyway, man?
On the next-gen Xbox One, PS4, and PC. Huh? I'm interested to see what changes are made. Or is there just simple lighting changes? Are they increasing the graphics to look sort of next-gen? Or is it just the same game? I mean, it's not a new game because it's already been out. So I wouldn't put GTA as a game that's been worked on, or Rockstar may have been just working on it from the beginning and just sort of waited for Microsoft and Sony to announce their new consoles. I am being invaded.
Fuck.
From Karova. Okay. Not that many places you can hide. Especially in the countryside. I know. Okay, person is right here. And there's no real anywhere you can hide unless you go down. Okay, the bike is there. So, I mean, there's no... There's no other area you can hide. Now I'm getting a little frustrated here. Okay, because it's not really... There's nowhere you can really hide. Thought I couldn't find you, but I did. Shocked my bike in the process, though. So as I said before, let's get this mission underway. A pit, oh my god. it was actually okay. I'm actually gonna sit back and actually watch this thing explode. I'm not gonna get anywhere near it. Okay. Well, that bike is done.
So now I need security clearance for Bloom HQ. Maybe why I turn Bloom's involved. These guys are up to something that's a lot more than CtOS. I hope Tebow knows what he's doing. Okay, I'm in position. Now what about these helicopters?
Wait for it. Go, don't lose it.
Alright, I gotta tail the helicopter. Sounds easy enough. I've actually done a lot of these in Saints Row, Grand Theft Auto, so it shouldn't be that hard. Shouldn't be that difficult either. I mean, there's no button. Typically in Grand Theft Auto game, there's a button that you can press to actually zoom in on the target, the sun in my eye, but there actually isn't, so I gotta sort of look towards the sky to sort of find where I'm going.
You have an end goal here?
What my location or the location that this thing is going.
Because it's a routine. Bloom HQ changes security protocol every day. That bird makes a trip over Pawnee with the new assignments.
So basically, the chopper's gonna lead us to the security chief.
And Bingo was her name, oh.
No. Okay, wait. I got it. Still got it, I'm not gonna lose you. Still got you.
Any sense? Wait a minute, it makes perfect sense. A lot of the Pawnee militia run security for Bloom, and a lot of them live in that pit of paranoia.
And one of them's the security chief.
With full access.
I can hardly wait.
You remember that bunch protecting the truck? Same gang. The Pawnee militia is made up of preppers, survivalists, anti-government types, my kind of people, which means they won't fuck around. Cold, dead hands, and all that crap.
Alright, so we got two big guys. I'm not gonna distract these guys, I can't. I can't do anything. I need one of these guys to come. Like over here. Okay, he's down. What? Okay, hold on.
Hovering over a trailer park.
Well, that doesn't make any sense. Wait a minute, it makes perfect sense. A lot of the Pawnee militia run security for Bloom, and a lot of them live in that pit of paranoia.
And one of them's the security chief.
With full access.
I can hardly wait.
You remember that bunch protecting the truck? Same gang. The Pawnee militia is made up of preppers. Survivalists, anti-government types, my kind of people. Which means they won't fuck around. Cold, dead hands, and all that crap.
So one of you...
Okay, so I need to profile...
Security chief. That one has potential. Who else?
Oh, okay, so I need to find the second guy.
Come on. Give me some options.
So there's two of them, I believe.
There.
Okay, take down both of them. These two guys are going down.
You got control of half.
This guy, one guy's down.
It's normal for Pawnee.
Ain't nothing normal in Pawnee.
So he's dead.
When Bloom started dumping money on this place, things took a turn for the weird.